The students, welcome to Vignan online classes. This is A. Srinivas, lecturer in physics, Vignan Junior College, Vadlamudi. Students, we completed current electricity, moving charges and magnetism, and digital classes. Now we comes to another important chapter. From this video onwards, in coming sessions, we are going to discuss another important chapter in second year, that is magnetism and matter. Magnetism and matter is the next part of our discussion. So this is also a very important chapter. In board exams, you may get 4 marks and as well as very short answer questions. It is a little bit in content point of view, less number of contents are present in this chapter and has an equal weightage. So in JE Main, you may get one question from this chapter with a very simple number of concepts. So this is our present discussion. Students, we are going to discuss about magnetism and matter. Mainly it dealt with permanent magnets or bar magnets which are equivalent to solenoid and elements of earth magnetism. These are the main 3 parts that we are going to discuss. So main topics of our discussion in this present chapter, new chapter, magnetism and matter, we mainly discuss the properties of permanent magnets followed by how the solenoid equivalent to bar magnet and then elements of earth magnetism. These are the main 3 parts of magnetism and matter. So let us move on to the contents that what we have to discuss in this chapter throughout the lesson. So let us observe the contents. Here, first one, we discuss about bar magnet and its properties. So we have permanent magnets. I think students, all of you played with magnets in your childhood. So all of you know about the magnet. You must saw, I think you might have saw the magnet also. Magnets are very familiar to all the students. So in case of bar magnets, what is bar magnet? What are the terms belongs to bar magnet and what are their properties? Next one, already in moving charges and magnetism, we know that current carrying loop behaves as a tiny magnetic dipole. So how the current carrying loop as a magnetic dipole and what is the expression for dipole moment? Here current carrying loop, one loop which carries the current acts as the magnetic dipole. If you consider a solenoid, we completed the solenoid already in moving charges and magnetism chapter. So solenoid also produces magnetic field along its axis, so that solenoid behaves like a permanent magnet. This permanent magnetic may be replaced by solenoid. So magnetic field produced by permanent magnet is equivalent to magnetic field produced by solenoid. How solenoid is equivalent to bar magnet will be discussed. And bar magnet and its dipole moment. Bar magnet has some dipole moment. What is the magnetic dipole moment of bar magnet? We have to discuss the expressions of them. Next, in case of bar magnets, Coulomb's law in magnetism. Already we have Coulomb's law between charges in electrostatics. Similar to that, there are some forces of either attraction or repulsion between magnetic poles. The forces of interaction between magnetic poles will be discussed in this part, that is Coulomb's law in magnetism. Next, important terms in magnetism. We have magnetic field induction, already we discussed about it, and we have magnetic momentum, we know that. Similarly, the intensity of magnetization, magnetizing field, there are some terms like relative permeability, susceptibility. These are some terms belongs to magnetism chapter. So that will be discussed in the coming sessions. And magnetic field due to a magnetic dipole. If you consider a bar magnet is a magnetic dipole. Students, you are observing bar magnet here. In this animation, throughout my explanation, behind me, there is a bar magnet. So this all the contents belongs to the bar magnet. This bar magnet having it has magnetic momentum, it has pole strength, and it applies some magnetic field along its axis or perpendicular to axis. Already we discussed about electric field due to electric dipole. Electric field due to electric dipole was discussed in charge and field chapter. Here in magnetism we have to discuss magnetic field due to magnetic dipole. This is a magnetic dipole and we have to discuss magnetic field due to magnetic dipole. Further, let us continue the contents of discussion. And when this magnetic dipole, what you are observing on the screen here, placed in uniform magnetic field, it experiences a torque. So torque experienced by a bar magnet known as the magnetic dipole in uniform magnetic field, or to rotate the magnet in uniform magnetic field, some work must be done on it, expression for work to be derived. Next, terrestrial magnetism. We know that Earth is a huge natural magnet, and we have to discuss about the strengths of magnetic field and elements of that magnetic field. That will be discussed in terrestrial magnetism and elements of Earth magnetism. Next one is tangent law. And magnetic material depend upon the magnetic strength, and they are classified into three categories, students: diamagnetic substances, paramagnetic substances, and ferromagnetic substances. That classification of magnetic substances will be discussed. Next, Curie's law of magnetism and hysteresis loop in magnetism. Students, in recent 2020 JEE main exams also, there were questions given in magnetism and matter. Depends upon numerical as well as theory, on hysteresis loop questions are framed, and in numericals questions are framed. That's why this is a very important chapter in objective point of view also. Students, so far I explained contents. There are totally 14 contents that I briefly explained for you. That will be discussed in the coming sessions. In coming videos, we continuously discuss about this contents belongs to magnetism and matter. Students, in this present part of session, in this video especially, so it may take 4 to 5 videos to complete this chapter. Especially in this part of our discussion, we confine to this 4 topics. I would like to explain these 4 topics. What is meant by bar magnet? Here in this video, you are observing a bar magnet in this animation. This is a physical structure of a bar magnet, and we have to discuss what is meant by bar magnet and what are properties of bar magnet. Next one, a current carrying loop carries some current in it equivalent to a tiny magnetic dipole. Then we write the expression for the magnetic dipole moment of tiny magnet. And solenoid is equivalent to bar magnet. We write the expression for magnetic field of solenoid. And next one is the bar magnet and dipole moment. Bar magnet's dipole moment and some extension of equations of them. This is our present part of discussion. In this video, in this session, I would like to explain these 4 contents out of 14 contents of magnetism and matter. So let us move on to the first topic of this magnetism and matter. Students, here I would like to explain what is the definition of magnetism. Magnetism, it is a phenomena of attracting magnetic substances like iron, nickel, cobalt, etc. We have magnetic substances like iron, nickel, cobalt. These are some examples of magnetic substances. Phenomena of attracting these magnetic substances is known as magnetism. Suppose if you consider this is a magnet, permanent bar magnet. This is a permanent bar magnet you are observing on the screen. If you put any magnetic substances like iron, cobalt, nickel, steel, these are immediately attracted by the permanent magnet. This phenomena of attracting the magnetic substance, you might have played in our childhood by the magnet with some iron pieces. When you put the magnet near iron, it is simply attracted. If you put the magnet near nickel or cobalt or iron, simply attracted. This phenomena or process of attracting magnetic substances is named as the magnetism. The substance which shows a body or substance the possessing property of magnetism is called magnet. So any substance which shows the phenomena of attracting magnetic material is known as the magnet. Magnetite is the very good example of a magnet, which has ability of attracting this iron, nickel, cobalt pieces. So a body or a substance which possesses this property is magnetism, is known as the magnet. Example for magnet is magnetite. So any magnet has two poles at extreme ends. So here in the screen, on the screen you are observing, I marked north and south poles of a magnet. So magnetic pole is a point near the end of the magnet, as I shown there. At the ends I put north at one end and south at other end. So a magnetic pole is a point near the end of the magnet where magnetism is concentrated. Here when you pour the pieces of iron, then most of the pieces are attracted at the poles rather than the edges. Rather than this neighbor points of the magnet, most of the pieces are attracting near the poles. It shows that the magnetic property is very high near the poles, near to the end of the magnet. These poles are located very near to the end of the magnet. So a magnetic pole is a point near the end of the magnet where magnetism is concentrated. So magnetic pole is a point where it lies near the end of the magnet, which shows this magnetism. So Earth is a natural magnet. I will show the diagram in the coming session. I will show the diagram of how the Earth is a natural magnet. Earth is a natural huge magnet. Earth has the property of magnetism. Earth is a huge magnet. So the region around a magnet, in which here you are observing the north and south poles of a bar magnet in this image, and we have some region around the magnet. So region around the magnet in which the magnetism property felt, magnetism property are attracting the iron pieces or interacting other magnets. This magnet may interact with other magnets, either attract or repel other magnets. This is possible to some region. So the region around which there is a possibility of interacting one magnet with another magnet or one magnet with another magnetic material is known as the magnetic field. So the region around a magnet in which it exerts a force on another magnet, force means interaction, as a repulsion force, one magnet may attract another magnet, one magnet may repel another magnet. So region around which or up to which one magnet may interact with another magnet is known as the magnetic field. That region is named as the magnetic field. Here in this image you are observing the magnetic field with the help of magnetic field lines. We located magnetic field with the help of magnetic field lines. Okay, these are some basic points about the magnetism. So let us move on. So this is the Earth. This is a cross-sectional image of Earth. So across the, along the line joining the poles, we take an image of cross-section of Earth. Along the line joining, let this be the north pole, geographical north pole, this is geographical south pole. So along the north to south pole, we consider a cross-sectional image of the Earth. So Earth has a natural magnetism. Earth is a natural huge magnet. Naturally huge magnet is Earth. And these are the geographical north and south poles, whereas these are the magnetic north and south poles. So geographic and magnetic north south poles are making some angle. We will discuss very clearly in the coming sessions. Just I am showing the image how the Earth behaves like the magnetism. So let us move on to the further points, properties. Now comes to properties of a bar magnet. So this is the clear image. Already I explained, this is the clear image of a bar magnet. It is a substance is like magnetite. Suppose if you consider a bar magnet, it has some length and it has some width. And it has attracting ability more at the edges. These are named as poles of a bar magnet. So comes to the first property. A freely suspended magnet aligns itself along north-south direction, because a freely suspended magnet, a bar magnet itself having north and south polarities. Okay, that is one point. Earth itself is a natural magnet. So this freely suspended magnet always attracted by the magnetic property of the Earth. It is influenced by Earth magnetism. That's why a freely, this is well known property. All of you studied in your lower classes also. Any freely suspended magnet always aligns in north-south direction due to influence of Earth magnetism. Unlike poles attract and like poles repel each other. I show this one in animation. In next part of our discussion, next to this slide, I show the animation which like poles attract, unlike poles attracts. North and south attract, whereas north-north repel, south-south repel. So unlike poles of a magnetic bar magnet attract each other and like poles repel each other. So magnetic poles always exist in pairs. Here this is the very important point, students. Third point. We can't find any magnet in isolated pole. Whereas in electricity, we have isolated charge. We may have isolated negative charge. We also have isolated positive charge. Isolated electron exists, isolated proton exists, isolated positron exists. So there is a possibility of having isolated electric charges, that is negative charge and positive charge. But we can't find the isolated magnetic pole. Here we have a bar magnet. It has north and south poles at two extreme ends of the bar magnet. Hence it is named as the dipole. This is magnetic dipole because magnet has two poles, north and south pole. Hence this is named as magnetic dipole. Magnetic dipole means it has two poles always. If you cut this magnet at the middle, then this one becomes north and this one becomes south. Even though you cut a magnet into two parts, once again it changes to a dipole structure. If you further divide it into two more pieces, that even small pieces also producing dipoles. This is the important part. Magnet always lie in form of a dipole. Monopole of magnet can't exist for any bar magnet. So magnetic poles always exist in pairs as shown in this image, north and south pole. Even though you cut the magnet into any tiny small parts, it must possessing two poles. Okay. Next comes to the point, a magnet can induce magnetism in other magnetic substances. Suppose, students, let us assume, let it be a bar magnet. So, though it is a remote, let us assume, let it be a bar magnet. When you move the bar magnet, take iron, let this be the iron rod. This is a bar magnet. In my right hand, I have the bar magnet, let it be bar magnet. In my left hand, let it be iron bar. When you move the magnet for a number of times, along the same direction, definitely the iron becomes a magnetic substance. It possesses magnetism. So that is the point here. A magnet can induce magnetism in another magnetic substances. Here it attracts magnetic substances. So magnetic, this is the first property I explained in the definition of magnetism. Magnetism is the phenomenon of attracting magnetic material. So any magnet has ability of attracting magnetic material such as iron, cobalt, nickel. So in this last part of our discussion, we discussed about mainly properties of magnet and some definition of magnetism and magnetic material. So here I explained, unlike poles attract each other, like poles repel each other. Let us look into the animation in which you observe the same thing. South pole and north pole are always attracting. Though they are kept at some distance, they simply attracted. Whereas like poles repel each other. Though you put south poles, they repel. Though you put north poles, they repel. So when two north poles in the lower image you are observing, when north poles put together, they repel. When south poles put together, they repel. When north and south poles are kept at some distance, they attract. So unlike poles of a bar magnet must have dipoles. Always possess dipole. One is north pole, another one is named as south pole. They are existing near end of magnet. Like poles always repel as shown in here. Unlike poles always attract as shown here. So next, let us move on. the representation of uniform magnetic field. Here I am showing some representations. Here, in coming sessions, we represent the magnetism with the help of some symbols, some arrow marks. Here, already we have some idea in moving charges and magnetism, but this is also very important in this part to continue. That's why representation of uniform magnetic field, uniform magnetic field in the plane, uniform magnetic field in the plane represented by equally spaced arrow marks. So magnetism is from the one side to another side. Here magnetic field is from the left to right. From left to right there is magnetic, uniform magnetic field in the plane of the board from left to right represented by this equally spaced arrow mark lines. Next, if you have magnetic field into the board, sometimes there is a magnetic field lies into the board, students. Magnetic field present into the board are represented in this diagram. Okay, so once again, see the diagram, magnetic field into the board. So with into marks, here I put into marks here, let us observe. With the help of this into marks, we represent magnetic field. If magnetic field is into the board, we represent it. Already, we have some idea about it in moving charges and magnetism, but we are recalling for the future purpose. If magnetic field is, this is the magnetic field into the board, into the plane of the diagram. If magnetic field is out of the board, like the students, they are represented as shown in the diagram. So uniform magnetic field perpendicular and emerging out of the plane of the diagram. See, you are in this animation, you are observing the magnetic field lies out of the board. So like this, here observing it, it lies out of the board. Okay. In this way, we represent three types of magnetic field. Magnetic field, all are uniform magnetic fields. One is in the plane of the paper, and another one is into the paper, third one is out of the paper. These are the symbolic representation of uniform magnetic field for three different directions. Okay, let us move on about the current loop as a magnetic dipole and dipole moment. So far I explained about the some properties of magnetism. Next comes to dipole, a current carrying loop. See the diagram, students. When you look into this diagram, here once again, here observe it, we have a current carrying loop. So in this way, the current is traveling in the loop. Students, a current carrying loop, carrying current I, behaves as a tiny magnetic dipole. Magnetic dipole means it must have a north pole and south pole. So it is also having north pole and south pole. In this present loop, you are observing current is traveling in anti-clockwise direction. Current is traveling. Hence, here if current is traveling in anti-clockwise direction, students, see, take your hand and with respect to this direction, current is traveling in anti-clockwise direction. Look into my hand. This is anti-clockwise direction. Clock moves like this. So current is traveling with respect to this face of the coil. Current is traveling in anti-clockwise direction. Thumb is like this. So this indicates north pole of magnetic dipole formed by the current carrying loop. Current carrying loop is a magnetic dipole having face of north pole. So like this, B bar. So this is north pole and this is south pole. Once again, I show it in animation. Students, let us observe. Here we have a current carrying loop. I explained and show the animation here. We have current carrying loop. With respect to me, it is in anti-clockwise direction. I already explained it. This is the direction of B bar, such that the back side is south and face towards me is north pole. So you find north pole when current is traveling like this in anti-clockwise direction. This is north pole. In that way, we calculated it. And here, this is the face of the coil having area of cross section. If A is the area of cross section, magnetic dipole moment of current carrying loop. Already we discussed about current carrying loop in moving charges and magnetism. That's why just I am recalling the formula. No need to explain the derivation now. We know it. Just I am recalling the formula. Magnetic dipole moment is given by M bar is equal to IA for one loop IA into n cap. N cap is the direction of area vector. This is the direction of area vector. Area vector is perpendicular to the, this is a cap direction, or let it be n cap direction. N cap is a unit vector perpendicular to face of the coil. Area vector, this is the area. Area is a plane surface of the coil. Then perpendicular to plane surface, we have area vector or normal vector. So normal vector to the face of the coil is the area vector direction. So magnetic moment is IA into N cap, IA. I is the current, A is the area of cross section. N cap is the unit vector perpendicular to the face of the coil, that is area vector. If there are capital N number of terms, NIA. If terms are there, we express it by the formula M is equal to NIA. If N number of terms are there, NIA. For one term, IA, direction is perpendicular to the face of the coil. So, SI unit of magnetic dipole moment of a current carrying loop is ampere meter square. SI unit is ampere meter square. Here, already I explained this tip to find the magnetic field. Next comes to solenoid. So, students, I explained that a current carrying loop behaves as a magnetic dipole. Current carrying loop behaves as a magnetic dipole. And one more important point is, a current carrying solenoid, we discussed about the solenoid in moving charges and magnetism, we know it very well, and we calculated magnetic field given by solenoid also. So current carrying solenoid is equivalent to bar magnet. The properties of bar magnet equivalent to properties of solenoid. So solenoid is equivalent to current carrying magnetic dipole or bar magnet. So bar magnet and current carrying solenoids are equal. So when we have the necessity or application of bar magnet, nowadays in spite of using bar magnet, we are using solenoids. In spite of using bar magnet, we are replace its function by solenoid nowadays. Hence bar magnet is a permanent magnet, solenoid is said to be electromagnet, because whenever current passing through the solenoid, it executes the magnetic field. So let us look into the diagram. This is the solenoid. Here we are observing the current carrying wire is circulated around the cylindrical structure. It becomes the solenoid. We discussed it very well in previous chapter, and we calculated magnetic field along x of solenoid is also mu naught ni, and this current carrying wire circulated around cylindrical structure becomes a solenoid. And as current is traveling like this, this is also traveling in anti-clockwise direction. Every loop, we have number of loops here. In every loop, current is circulating in anti-clockwise direction. Hence, this indicates the north pole of bar magnet, with so other end becomes south pole. Now, let us observe the animation. How this solenoid equal to bar magnet, like this. Here, this is solenoid. It is equivalent to bar magnet. Okay. Here, students, this is bar magnet. Actually, a solenoid is equivalent to bar magnet. That is my discussion. Nothing to explain about solenoid. We discussed in moving charges and magnetism. Here, students, let us continue our discussion about bar magnets. Here, let us consider a bar magnet here. See the students, once again, let us look into the bar magnet shown here. So generally magnet is also in the same color, it is in gray color most probably. Here this is north pole. Pole is not exactly at the end, but nearer to the end, just inside. See, pole is existing nearer to the end, but not exactly end, just inside the end of solenoid we have poles. So let it be north pole of bar magnet. This is south pole. Look into the magnet. Always look into the magnet. I am showing the animations belongs to it. Here, length of, this is the magnetic moment. Students, the magnetic moment of bar magnet is always directed from south to north pole of magnet. See, once again, one more time, let us observe. The magnetic moment represented by capital M bar, it is directed from south to north pole of bar magnet. Let us observe it, the animation. Next one, the length of magnet. This is magnetic length. Magnetic length is the length between the poles of magnet. distance between two poles, north pole and south pole, which are located just inside the ends. Here at this point we have north pole, at this point we have south pole. They are not at the end points, they are just inside the end. So the distance between two poles of magnet, so once again here you observe it, distance between two ends of the magnet is magnetic length, whereas geometrical length in blue line, with the help of blue line we are representing geometrical length. Geometrical length is the actual length of magnet, that is the distance between ends of the magnet. So once again, distance between ends of the magnet is geometrical length. We have two lengths, magnetic length and geometrical length. So this is the good information regarding magnet. Then the line joining the poles of magnet is called magnetic axis. So here we draw magnetic axis. This is magnetic axis. Line joining the poles of magnet is magnetic axis. In further derivations, we consider data like this. Consider a point on the axis of magnet. Then what is axis? That's what I explained here. Line joining the poles of magnet is called magnetic axis. The distance between poles of magnet is called magnetic length, as shown here. And distance between the ends of magnet, as shown in blue line, is geometrical length. The relation is the magnetic length is 5 by 6 times geometrical length. This is the relation. LM, magnetic length, is 5 by 6 times geometrical length, and in decimal part, that is numerically equal to 0.84. So ratio of, here I write the ratio of magnetic length to geometrical length is 0.84. In some numericals we use this data, students. Here let us discuss, continue the discussion of bar magnet here, students. Here so once again consider the magnet, bar magnet. Now I would like to explain about magnetic dipole moment, magnetic dipole moment of a permanent bar magnet. So magnetic dipole moment of permanent magnet, so the before defining dipole moment, let me have the definition of magnetic dipole. A pair of magnetic poles of equal and opposite strength separated by finite distance. A pair of magnetic poles, we have north pole here and south pole here. A pair of magnetic poles of equal and opposite strengths separated by finite distance is called magnetic dipole. Hence any bar magnet must having a pair of opposite poles separated by some distance. So every magnet itself becomes a magnetic dipole, and the magnetic length, magnetic, the magnitude of dipole moment is the product of pole strength and separation. Here the definition is, if M is the magnetic dipole moment, it is the product of pole strength and the length of magnet. We represent length of magnet, generally we represent magnetic length by the term 2L. From the center each pole is at L. If you assume from the center each pole is L, then magnetic length between the poles is 2L. The product of pole strength and length of magnet, that's what I write here. The magnitude of dipole moment is the product of pole strength M and the separation between the poles, M into 2L. It is known as magnetic dipole moment. So M into 2L, and its SI unit is ampere meter square. So this is about, whereas SI unit of pole strength is ampere meter. Pole strength is small m, its SI unit is ampere meter. And magnetic moment is the product of pole strength and length of magnet, its SI unit is ampere meter square. Pole strength is a scalar. Remember, magnetic moment is a vector which is directed along the length of magnet. The direction of magnetic moment is always from south to north pole of magnet. South to north pole, we have the